There's another verse from John's Gospel. It says, "He that believes on the Son has everlasting life, and that he believes not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him." Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that hears my word and believes in him that sent me has everlasting life and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. That's a song that was inspired, of course, by Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. And it tells us also that goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And it also says that I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In fact, in the New Testament, Jesus revealed He said, I am the good shepherd, and the good shepherd gives his life for the sheep, which is exactly what he did at Calvary. So that's from Psalm 23 in the New Testament also. I'm going to do an old song this time that Elvis Presley made famous. He didn't write it, of course, but he brought it to a whole new audience. It's a song called How Great Thou Art. And just let you know that God commends his love towards us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And much more than being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. Amen. Play a classical tune this time. I'd love to play Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, but I'm not able to. This one was written by Giuseppe Verdi. He was inspired by Psalm 137 when he wrote it, the chorus of the Hebrew slaves. And just thought I'd throw in this one from Acts, the Acts of the Apostles. And it says, in no other is there salvation, for there is no other name under heaven given among men through which we may have salvation. And you know, and they said, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved, you and your whole house. And whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Can I hear an amen to that from the believers? Bless God, amen. Well, you know, I've just got one more time for one more tune, and I'm going to play a fast one this time. I hope you don't mind that too much. And but as it is written, eye has not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him. I'm going to say that one again. I think it's a good verse. As it is written, eye has not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things that God has prepared for them that love him. I'm going to play a tune. Last tune is called Hava Nagila. I know very little of the Hebrew language, but I found out that Hava Nagila means let us rejoice. And the word of the Lord says that this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen? Okay, God bless you, folks. I'm going to leave you with this one. Hava Nagila, let us rejoice. Here we go.
Welcome. We know you can sing now, so we would love if you would join us singing. If you would like to stand, we'd love if you would stand, because this first song says we stand and lift up our hands. All right, so feel free to join us. All right.
Thank you. great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, we'll see how great is our God.
How great is our God.
How great. Great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, we'll see how great is our God. Then sings my soul.
We have two fire exits on the back here, and I feel like the airplane attendant. On this side and this side, two exits back here, and then the assembly point is at the back fence, right? We all know now, there's already a fire in this place.
Lord, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the is found is where you are. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Jesus.